Hello, friends and family on social media. I needed a quick way to get an important update out there, just to let everybody who didn't already know of the not-so-significant event that's occurred. I got my head shaved. I speak in past tense, despite the obvious length of my hair, because it's already done. Hence one of the things that I love about film documentation. I write for the future, speaking of the past, yet always addressing the present moment. No matter how many times you rewatch this video, I will always be speaking to you right now. I began writing the bits and pieces for this script in January 2015, waiting to present it alongside my crazy decision. What flourished from an impulsive thought earlier this year led to something I realized I genuinely wanted and have wanted for quite some time. I came to see that the only idea holding me back all these months is the consequential lack of a feminine image, which my long hair somehow exemplifies. We'll come back to image a little later. I think it's remarkable how something as simple as the hair on our heads can change everything. When I started talking to people about shaving my head, some felt it necessary to remind me that,
"Oh my gosh, Jen, but you have such thick, long hair."
It's like, thanks for letting me know. That's sort of why I want it gone. I was met with a lot of confusion. The most popular question being,
"Why would you cut all your hair off?"
Well, why not? I want to shake things up a little. Plus, it gets in my eyes, gets in my food, sticks to my armpits when I run, and sticks to my back when I shower. Yeah, I'm ready for a change. And then there were those who just plain told me,
"It won't look nice."
To which I replied, "That's not the point. Frankly, I'm terrified by the idea. To some degree, I know I'm going to regret this. Because apparently, an abundance of hair is important to femininity. In all the right places, of course. We know them well, all of these little rules we must follow in order to not get pointed and laughed at. Different rules for men and women, of course. As much as I'd like to say otherwise, gender plays a major role in identity. One affects the other, they become interchangeable, and next thing you know, you feel like shit, not for something you did wrong, but rather for someone you don't want to pretend to be. I'm tired of these expectations, of these stereotypes, and of being judged for my body hair in a way that men are never criticized simply because my reproductive organs are internal. I'm guilty of judging as well. Trust me, we've all been conditioned into adhering to these images. On the one side, you have male and female. And on the other, you have the cultural images of masculine and feminine. Let's let these conveniently secluded boxes serve as representation. The images we create with our behavior and appearance reinforce our identity. Judith Butler refers to this as gender performance. It's actually a thing. Because we put ourselves into these little boxes that we have complete control over, yet as a society, choose to uphold. The only thing keeping the principles of masculinity and femininity alive is us. We choose to reward those that pick characteristics from their appropriate box, and we socially punish individuals that pick an item from the wrong box. To give you a few known examples, let's together file these characteristics from my stereotype folder. Facial hair is a socially masculine trait. A woman with a little upper lip hair or sideburns is very likely to be mocked and will probably feel the pressure to shave. Dresses and skirts are feminine. How better to emasculate a man than to have him walk around downtown on a Friday night in a sundress? Expressions of sexual availability are predominantly masculine. A sexually expressive woman is a slut. Now, freedom of emotion falls into the feminine box. An emotionally sensitive man is a pussy. Aggression is a masculine expectation. Boys will be boys, am I right? Two young boys fighting are just building character, but two young girls doing the same must be separated before someone's hurt. Family values are a feminine assumption. A man who doesn't want kids is career-oriented. A woman with the same ambition is being selfish and has no maternal instinct. The predominant masculine image has short hair. And the image of femininity has long hair. These symbolic and societal representations are derived from our culture. They vary with history, pressures, environment, and time. I realize as the big day approaches that the reason I write this, with the intention of reading it aloud to you right now, is my way of justifying my decision. I write as if my actions deserve an explanation, and that's what this is. The real answer to that recurring question from earlier of,
why would you cut all your hair off?
I'm tired of these gendered boxes dictating the way I should behave. I just wish it hadn't taken me this long to stop caring. I'm not going to limit myself to one box when there's so much cool stuff in here.
Comme Sigourney Weaver dans Alien.
Ah oui!
Tu devrais te raser, mais tu te rases comme moi.
Mais non, ça c'est une autre.